If you are a Visual Studio Code user, no matter your role, you might have faced the situation of accidentally modifying your files. That is expected because, by default, files and folders in Visual Studio Code are writable. Luckily for us, there is a feature that allows us to set them as read-only and avoid unpleasant situations. Before diving into this, just know that this feature is available in version 1.79 and above. Okay, so at this point I have a folder or directory and under it two other folders. If I open these files, like this one and this one, I'll actually split them. So on the left side I have DevApp and on the right side I have ProdApp. Let me drag this a little. Okay, and now I can edit both of them. I can type here something, here as well, and they are both writable. The read-only feature provides flexibility, meaning we can lock a specific file, a specific folder, or even exclude specific path. But let's take everything one by one. First of all, I'll open the command palette by pressing Ctrl-Shift-P, and here we can search for read-only. We have three options: to reset the active editor read-only, to set it as read-only, or to toggle the active editor as read-only. Basically, the toggle will do the opposite setting. So if it is writable now, it will set it as read-only. If it is read-only, it will set it as writable. So what I'll do, I'll just set active editor in read-only in session. As we can see, now we got lock here. If we try to type something, we get this warning saying editor is read-only because the file was set read-only in this session. Click here to set writable. So to set it writable, we can click here, or we can open again Ctrl-Shift-P to open the command palette and toggle or reset it. If we check the one on the right side, we can still modify it. Okay, so let me remove this. And now for the one on the left side, I'll press again Ctrl-Shift-P and I'll press on reset. It is now writable again. Now let's say I want to set read-only at folder level. So what I will do, I'll click on File, Preferences, Settings, and search for read-only. We mostly care about read-only exclude and read-only include. Here we can add some patterns. For example, I click on pattern, and let's say we want to have read-only everything under my app. So I'll right-click, copy path, and paste it. Additionally, what we need to add is another slash and a double asterisk. This syntax in VS Code will match any number of path segments, including none. So I click on OK. And now we can see that the files that we open have a lock and they are read-only. So this one, if I try to modify, we get that warning, and the same for the one on the right side. Even if I open one of these Docker files, for example, we can see that it has the lock, and again, we cannot modify it, and the same will happen for this one above. So basically, all our files under my app are read-only. Let me close the Docker files. I'll drag this here. And now, let's say we want to add an exception. We want everything under my app to be read-only, but for ProdApp, we want it to be writable. So again, I'll click on File, Preferences, Settings, search for read only. Here under read only exclude, I'll add a pattern. I'll copy for ProdApp the path. Again, with a double asterisk. Okay. Let me close the settings here and here as well. I'll make this equal. Good. And now we can see here that index.html that is under prod app doesn't have the lock, while the one under devapp has the lock. So now what I will do, I will type here something. We can modify the one that is under prod app, but the one that is under dev app is read only. So we cannot modify it because of the settings we just put in place. Okay, let's now have everything as it was. So I'll remove this from here. I'll go again to the settings, search for read only, and I will remove this exclude item, and I'll also remove this include item. Okay, now I'm ready to close the setting and everything is the way it was before. Thank you for tuning in. I hope you found this tip useful. If you enjoyed this content and found it valuable, don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and ring the notification bell to stay updated. Your support means a lot to me, and I cannot wait to bring you more insightful content. Until next time, take care and all the best.